This episode of Carding is brought to you by Unicorn, Power Scour, Fiber Wash, and Rinse. Keep your drum carder and other fiber prep tools clean by only using fibers washed with Unicorn. Stock up on Unicorn with my exclusive coupon. Enter HTSY for 20% off your entire order at unicornclean.com. Welcome back to Carding and our tutorial, Vermont Autumn. In this tutorial, I'm going to be using a technique that I've seen Sarah Adams do on her blog, Atomic Blue Fiber, where we're going to be taking stripes and then blending it twice. So this is one of the only tutorials in my series where we will blend this batt twice. And the reason I'm doing that is because as I look at pictures of Vermont, autumn in Vermont, I notice that the trees are kind of all blended together. It's not like we have stripes of trees like in other landscapes that I've seen. So I thought that would be a great opportunity to show this blending technique. So let's start by just layering colors, and it doesn't matter what order it's in. And this is the first time I've ever done this technique. So we'll see. I'm gonna do it by memory. I'm pretty sure I remember how to do it. We will find out. Okay, I think what I'm going to do, because I am, when I'm doing something that's been inspired by someone else, I have to add my own twist on it. I hate being accused of copying. Imitation is the sincerest form of flattery, and one of the reasons why I teach these classes is because I love inspiring people, and I totally don't mind if you literally do the exact same colors I do. I think when you're an educator, students will imitate what they see you doing, and I love that. I don't mind being copied at all. But it does kind of, it's a pet peeve of mine to feel like someone could say that I'm copying. So, because I'm so not into copying, I don't have time to copy. But since I learned this from someone else, I'm going to add my own twist onto it. We are going to, let's see, break this. We're going to tear this batt up into four sections. Okay, one, two, three, four. These are my four sections. So now I'm going to hold the batt. Rather than putting it through the carder the same way it was carded, I'm going to hold it kind of like a sandwich where the colors are all on top of each other and blend it through the bottom drum. This is what I've seen other people do. So this is not my original idea. And I'm kind of at a point where, like, I love giving credit. I try to give credit for every single thing that I've learned from everyone else. But I think there comes a point when we all just need to let each other be creative and stop comparing. So I'm going to do another layer, top to bottom, and just bring it through. I really love how this is looking. That's really, really, really pretty. I'm really impressed by that. That is just gorgeous. Let's do another layer. I'm not sure where the top and the bottom is of this, so I'm just gonna hold it and bring it through. Beautiful. So my idea, what I'm going to add to this is, because what I've seen is, and that's the end, I'm going to go ahead and add stripes of color on top of this and some sparkle. So I think this is lacking a little bit of yellow. So I'll add more yellow to this. And some more brown. And this technique of double blending, you could do that with any of the different batt colorways from this series for a more uniform fiber look, as well as a more blended batt. I'm almost curious to see if I could fit my last chunk of fiber on top of this. We'll see. There we go. I love it. I love it, love it, love it. So I have not seen somebody hold the chunk of fiber and paint it on top, so that's something different. And I have not seen someone double blend a batt and then add solid layers within it, so that's something different. The opportunities are endless, and I'm sure there's millions of people, thousands, millions, billions, doing this exact same thing around the world and not worrying about who else is doing it too. And that's where I like to hang out. Why worry? It's all fun. Out with my copying lesson. I think that is beautiful. Can definitely see the inspiration of the blended deciduous trees in Vermont in this batt. Lovely. Thank you, Sarah, for showing me how it's done. And thank you for all the other artisans who have educated and taught me throughout this process. Now I want you to take this and go make one exactly like it, because it's super fun. Thanks for watching and happy carding.